An autism singer who blew up by creating the weirdest but the finest melody ever. Units Genshi. Even if you never heard of his name before, you've probably heard his song before, such as Kanden. And Ainen Kalainen. And many, many amazing songs from him. You can even say, without Units, the Japanese pop culture would change forever. Units Genshi was born on March 10, 1991, in Japan, Tokushima City. His father goes to a computer-related company, but since his father doesn't really talk to him, there is a father and son issue. And his mother is a family housewife who has an art lesson. If you think Units Genshi is a stage name, then you are very wrong. Despite having a very uncommon last name, but not even once did Units ask his parents about his name. Deep inside, he has a special understanding of his name. Gen came from kanji kurodo, which have a meaning for professionals. And Shi were from shisho, which means outstanding in a specific field, and that is kenshi. Ever since he was young, Units has always been difficult to communicate with. He wants to be a normal person, but nobody understands how he really feels, which makes him deep in pain and feel like a monster. When he was 20, Units' condition was diagnosed to be high-functioning autism. Units once described his condition to be feeling no sense of belonging, both mentally and physically, which is the main reason why he doesn't feel like talking to anyone, and is the main reason why he has no friends. In his free time, Units like to build a special world inside his mind. This rich imagination comes from painting, which has been his hobby ever since childhood. Units really likes to read manga, which is the name for Japanese comic books, especially the shonen ones, such as Naruto, Dragon Ball, and such. Units once even dreamed about being a manga author. Besides manga, he also likes reading. The detailed story projection from the novel has also changed Units' future music career. When he was in 5th grade, his family bought a computer, and that has been his life-changing moment ever since. The computer carries all his curiosity, especially a trending app called Flash Animation, which is an animation app that plays background music the same time. Units' favorite music are from a band called Bumble Chicken. Units is a creator. He often creates paintings in his imaginary world as a way to communicate to himself. And Bumble Chicken's music has a strong sense of pictures, which is what drags himself into it the most. And later on, it also became one of his motivations. I also want to make something like that. Can I reach that level too? All of a sudden, it seems Units has finally found his goal. Under the motivations, he quickly bought a 20,000 yen guitar and started his way as Units Genshi. But before that, there's one more stop to go. Units gathered a band in his junior high year and named it Late Rabbit Edda, and went all over the country to contest. Their band was quickly disbanded because Units can't communicate to the band members normally and feels like no one understands what he's saying, so he lost interest in it quickly. In the year of 2009, an app called Bokalobo, or known as Bokalo, has attracted Units' attention. Bokalo is an electronic music text-to-speech app that's developed by Yamaha in 2003. When you enter the melody and lyrics, the system will automatically develop a human voice that will sing the song. Hatsune Miku is also from Bokalo, and is the most known character and most used character. During this time, Units used the nickname as Hachi and started producing music using this app. Units also described himself as escaping to the internet from reality. At first, most of the music was drawn by Units using a mouse, little by little, to trace the pictures. So Units was also known as Mouse Warrior. Units feels like working by himself makes him feel freer, and will also be easier to create wild music pieces, and the name Hachi came from his sister. Hachi in Japan means the number 8, so a lot of fans in Asia would call him Hachi-sama. Hachi posted all his early work on a video platform called Nico Nico. And on that platform, you can also watch a lot of Hachisama's early work, such as Ohimisama ba Denshi o Deneru. In the year 2009, Nico Nico starts to get viral, and the name Hachi is also starting to get popular. Gyakuzaisei, or reverse regeneration, is also a critical factor for Hachi. Reverse backward is a kind of song where you play it normally, which just sounds fine, but once you played it backward, you will mishear everything, and it will show a different perspective of the song. A famous example will be Stairway to Heaven. Once you play the song backward, it will feel like a song that was written by Satan. Eunice achieved over 10 million views on one of the best electronic music in Japan, Matoru Yushika. During Matoru Yushika, at first, you will feel the music to be really messy, where the melody is all over the place. But every single note is on a beat, and that's the charm of Eunice Genshi's music, Contradiction. Eunice Genshi has done a lot of interviews about the reason why he left Boccalo and leaving behind the name Hachi. But overall, he just felt lonely by himself and feels like there's an invisible wall between him and the viewers. So in 2012, Eunice made his first step. Go no Yorensei. Not only is the first official music piece that he sang by himself, but it's also his last piece as Hachi. Eunice joined a group of multiple famous producers called Balloon and created his first ever album by the name Eunice Genshi, G-U-L-O-B. The first ever album under the name Eunice Genshi got 6th place on Oricon. It was a great score, but Eunice is both disappointed and shocked, because in his heart, this album is the perfect J-pop. Later that year, he released Yankee. Eunice's second album was more welcome and more fit for the current era. Yankee means American. The album was telling stories about people moving to America. In the year of 2015, Eunice's third album, Birdman, was released. Birdman, the name came from the band in Fairy Tale, Town Musicians of Birdman. The story was about four animals decided to escape the farm and go to a place called Birdman, where they're gonna create a band, but for some unknown reason, which is also spoilers, they eventually decided to settle in the forest. During his 2016 performance, the music Unbelievers he used, which represents the people that don't believe in certain things, were also believing in it. The irony between it is what Eunice is trying to express in this album. 2016, the first ever music video with Eunice dancing in it, Loser, is a strong song with both melody and lyrics, which got second place on Oricon. In 2017 is a year where Eunice collaborated the most. In February, Eunice collaborates with the anime Three Gods and a Lion, Olio. And in June, Eunice was the opening singer for Boku no Hero Academia Season 2, Peace Sign. And the number one hit song in Japan, Uchiyage Hanabi, collaborated with singer Daoko for the animated movie Fireworks, Should We See It From the Side or the Bottom? That song was even more popular than the movie itself. Eunice also collaborated with one of his actor friends, Suda Masaki, and by the end of the year, Eunice released his fourth album, Bootleg. This album has also successfully won the number one place on Oldico.
どれだけ背丈が変わろうとも変わらない何かがありますように。
2018, Yunus collaborated with a Japanese TV show on Natural and created one of the best hip J-pop songs ever, Lemon. On Natural is a TV show that is based on the theme death, so the song was also written about life and death. But just when the song was nearly finished, the unfortunate thing happened. Yunus' grandfather passed away. This has brought an incredibly shock to him. He started to think more deep in the topic of death, and keep on asking himself the same question. Have I ever taken death seriously? With this thought in mind, Yunus restarted the song from scratch, and finally, it became the song that we all know.
夢ならばどれほど良かったでしょう。未だにあなたのことを夢に見る。
Not only the new version of Lemon fits the TV show theme better, it also brought a lot of fame and awards to Yunus. Not only he took over Oliko for 52 weeks straight as number one karaoke hit song, he also became a regular guest in Japanese TV programs. Just when everyone thought Yunus was gonna keep up with modern day J-pop music, later October, Flamingo was born. Yunus said that the reason he created Flamingo is so more of his fans will understand what kind of singer he is and what kind of music he wants to express with, which also identifies his personality. Recently, Yunus has released his 11th album, Pale Blue, with a drama love hit song, Pale Blue, is specifically made for Japanese TV show, Legal Cuts, which is a show that talks about the modern day marriage issue that I've been currently watching and enjoying a lot. This is a love theme song which Yunus haven't done in a really long time. I'll be talking more specific on this song in another video. From a person who afraid of talking to people, to a brilliant singer that collaborated with multiple talented singers and made multiple amazing songs, Yunus' story is also telling us that changes can be made. Some might be correct, some might be wrong, but if you continue, one day you succeed. Just like how Yunus was so depressed, how his first album didn't make it to the number one spot on Oldico, but later on, he kept on trying and finally achieved his goal. Thank you for watching this video. This is my first episode for the series Almighty Asia Anecdote. And I know there's some, you know, weird grammar mistake and audio issues because unfortunately my microphone ran out of juice in the middle of recording. So you can tell later on the recording is really messy and it's all over the place. There's editing issues as well. I promise from now on the videos will be fixed. Okay. And talking about the future of this channel, we'll probably be talking about more anime stuff. And it won't be just focusing on Japan, it's gonna be all Asia. We're gonna talk about all kind of stuff, not just musicians, not just artists, not just songs, all kind of stuff. So please subscribe and share and like this video. Thank you so much. I'll see you guys next time. Bye bye.